ಪ್ರಪನ್ನ ಪಾರಿಜಾತಾಯ ತೋತ್ರಭೇತ್ರೈಕಪಾಣಯೇ ಜ್ಞಾನಮುದ್ರಾಯ ಕೃಷ್ಣಾಯ ಗೀತಾಮೃತದುಹೇ ನಮಃ. ಓಂ ನಮೋ ವೆಂಕಟೇಶಾಯ. ಮೈ ಬೆಸ್ಟ್ ವಿಶಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಬ್ಲೆಸ್ಸಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಟು ಆಲ್ ದ ವೀವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಶ್ರೀ ವೆಂಕಟೇಶ್ವರ ಭಕ್ತಿ ಚಾನಲ್. ಹರಿಹಿ ಓಂ. ನಮಸ್ಕಾರ. ಶ್ರೀಮದ್ ಭಗವದ್ಗೀತಾ ಚಾಪ್ಟರ್ ನಂಬರ್ 1 ಶ್ಲೋಕ ನಂಬರ್ 35. ನಿಹತ್ಯಧಾರ್ತರಾಷ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ನ ಕಾ ಪ್ರೀತಿ ಸ್ಯಾಜ್ಜನಾರ್ದನ ಪಾಪಮೇವಾಶ್ರಯೇದಸ್ಮಾನ್ ಹತ್ವೈತಾನಾತತಾಯಿನಃ. ಆಸ್ ವಿ ಸಾ ಇನ್ ದ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಸೆಷನ್, ದಿ ಅರ್ಜುನ ಹೂ ವಾಸ್ ಕನ್ಫ್ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಮೇಡ್ ಅ ರಾಂಗ್ ಡಿಸಿಷನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಹಿ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಸೇಸ್ ಅಗೈನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಅಗೈನ್ ಸ್ವಜನಾಹ. 3 or 4 ಟೈಮ್ಸ್ ಹಿ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಟೋಲ್ಡ್ ಸ್ವಜನಾಹ, ಸ್ವಬಾಂಧವಾನ್. And also he says all these atatayinaha, wrongdoers, if I kill them, I will be affected by papa. Now he brings a quotation which is from karma dharma theory. A theory of karma, that's the topic we were discussing with. Usually, you know, in India, if you are born, you are definitely will be aware about karma phala. When people are sad, they say that this is my fate, karma phala. And every elderly people would say that this is your destiny, your karma phala, your prarabdha karma, your praptam or prarabdham. So what exactly the karma theory? Is it everything already planned? It means what? If I see my horoscope, so can I predict whatever there is in the horoscope? Will it happen as it is? Then what? I need not work. I need not worry. There are lots of questions which is unanswered by the society. Even our parents are not aware, our relatives are not aware. Therefore what? We live with half our knowledge of everything what we do. Now this subject matter, so which we dealt with last session, I will give a kind of a recap. Now Arjuna is talking about papa. Papa means what? If we want to know the meaning of the word papa, then we have to know the meaning of punya, the word punya. Then what these two, papa and punya are nothing but a result of karma. Then what is karma? And that karma means what? How it provides papa and punya, that's what we saw in the last session. I made it like a points, you know. Though there are definitions given in our scriptures, it's beyond our understanding. People say, you know, if you give money for a charitable trust, it's punya. If providing food for others is punya. Okay, constructing temple is punya. And what some people say, if you go padayatra, like going walk for a pilgrim, that's also called punya. Then what exactly dharma is? The definition which I said yesterday, dharati iti dharmaha, dharyate anenava iti dharmaha, yagadireva dharmaha. These are the quotations. But we are not going to directly shoot these quotations, means these words from Vedas, just we will realize, understand from our own standpoint. When we analyze from our side, that would be easy to understand for us. I gave the example of killing mosquito. Then what is karma means? Anything that which you do with an intention. Without an intention, no karma is available in this world. Intention means purpose. Without purpose, no karma you can see. Swamiji, how it would be possible? Now we don't find any purpose to the sun which keeps burning itself. We don't see any purpose of the river which is keep on flowing. And all these five elemental aspects, they keep on working a lot. My dear, we may not aware about the purpose what they have. Do you know what the purpose that you have? Are you aware about it? Not completely. Now for example, without purpose, no action. If I show like this, this is an action. And this action, there must be purpose. If you think some purpose, if you fix the goal, okay, that has the goal. If you are not fixing the goal, that has some other goal, which the karma is getting its own manifestation towards you. For example, when you are going in a queue, you want to reach the destiny. If you are standing in a temple for a darshana, okay? So you are with an intention to have darshana, okay? But you don't have time, means within 10 minutes or 20 minutes, you didn't fix a time. Because when we go to the temples, we should not have fixing time, but we don't have options nowadays because people are going office in a hurry, so they push from the behind. Now, though you don't have a purpose, means within this time I have to have the darshana, but people push you in the queue. That's what karma is. Karma from your side, karma from other sources. It's very deep. Therefore, gahana karmano gatihi. Even Krishna Paramatma says, so in order to understand karma, is it impossible? Because your body, mind and sense complex, they are nothing but karma phala. Being the product of karma, to realize, understand completely karma is absolutely impossible. Is there any another way? Yes, that the way the Bhagavad Gita approaches. Therefore, the first chapter talks about the problems of every individual. What are the problems may be possible. And the second chapter gives Brahma Jnanam and Atma Jnanam and Vishaya Jnanam, both karma, knowledge and everything. Then third chapter, fourth chapter, fifth chapter, three chapters they deal only with karma and karma phala, karma yoga, jnana karma, sannyasa yoga, karma sannyasa yoga. All these three chapters are there to discuss elaborately about this karma. Don't worry if you are not understanding anything right now which I say. Okay? Then, the fifth chapter comes jnana yoga. You see, that is the sequence. Once you have to be clear with you, because everything is nothing but karma phala. We will come back again from yesterday's sessions, means the last episode, which I said, you know, number one, point number one is every karma has got its own fruit. And fruit cannot be separated from karma. I gave the example of clap and its sound. Then these fruits are two kinds. I said seen fruit, unseen fruit. The seen fruits are called drishta phalam. Unseen fruits are known as adrishta phalam. For example, I said killing mosquito, you have fixed a goal to kill the mosquito, you achieved it, now the action is completed. The mission is accomplished. At the same time, one fruit is seen by you which can be understood, the death of mosquito. At the same time, one more account will be added in your account. That subtle account is maintained by that dharma, that power which maintains your karma account is also known as dharma, a power which calculates everything. Dharati anena iti dharmaha. And that karma phala, you know, one more point, the karma phala, this adrashta karma phala are two kinds. When you kill a creature, you will be provided the same painful experience through some incidents. Even your relative can be cause for that. For example, so one of my students, he was just having a meditation or some japa at home. His mother was cutting vegetables, and I suppose it's a big vegetable or something. She was very fast. That knife slipped from her hand. He got injured. Now mother didn't have any intention, but the karma phala, it comes through anybody. It may come through our own thought. And that karma phala is nothing but adrushta phalam. The life is full of adrushta. That adrushta, punya and papa. When you kill the mosquito, it will give a painful experiences, bringing so many incidents. So those incidents are, it's established. The whole entire universe is meant for you to enjoy your karma phala. Can you believe it? That's the truth. Now this world is providing your karma phala, that every establishment is done by that system. That's what called dharma. And that karma phala, painful karma phala, is called papam. Happiest karma phala experience, happiest experience, by providing some kind of incidents or maybe accidents, that is called punya phala. Now finally we have to realize karma can give punya and papa. Okay, now which karma will produce punya and papa? That's what I said. Human being, we don't have the capacity to judge whether a karma will produce punya or papa. We don't have the capacity. And one more point I forgot to tell you yesterday. See, if you perform a karma, so you have to enjoy the karma phala. No choice. Because if you are kill a mosquito, you alone have to enjoy the painful experience. You cannot transfer this experience to somebody else. That's the system of the universe. Therefore, what? You have to be confident enough. If you do good things, definitely you alone will be enjoying it. That adrishtam phalam. No option. But now the problem is, we cannot judge. You know, for example, one incident happened in my life itself. When my guru taught this karma theory, and I got in my mind, okay, chalo. So if you are intelligent enough to realize the theory of karma, then what? You will conclude, yes, if I want to be happy, then what? I should have more punya. Exactly. We need to have more punya. If I have the punya, I can be happiest person. I can be endowed with happiest experience always. And one karma will produce one phala. So once you enjoy it, that phala will be completed. Now when I heard it, now I was with an urge to earn punya. How can we earn punya? Doing good thing for others. Is there any norms that especially this karma will produce punya? No norms. Anything you do, good thing. Then the next day itself, somebody gave some fruits. It's a small red fruits. You might have heard or seen somewhere. That fruit, he said that this is called sugar fruits. Then I said, what is it? He said, no, actually if you are a diabetic patient, okay, if you have this fruit, your diabetic, that disease will be reduced. Then I didn't believe. He said, no, it's proved. Then I thought, okay, I'm not a diabetic patient. Then suddenly I remembered one of my neighbors who were staying in the ashrama. So there was an old man who has that sugar complaint. Then I thought, okay, he is the diabetic patient. Okay, if I give this fruit to him, good, I can earn punya phala. Then I received the fruits. I reached that old man who had completed breakfast. And I said, Dada, how are you? See now, this how are you is having an intention to earn punya. No wrong, nothing wrong in that. Then said, Acha beta, how are you? Then I said, Dada, you see these fruits, this is good for you. Just have it. Then he said, good for what? Just I have completed my breakfast. I don't want to take anything. And that too, I have taken sugar tablet. So beta, please you have it. But I didn't leave because I was pressurized to earn punya. Okay. Therefore, what I did? I did, you know, this is very good for sugar patient. For you alone, I asked from somebody. Therefore, please Dada, have it. Then he said, okay, yes, he seems to be a very good brahmachari, okay. So he wants to do good thing for me. Then he had it. It was morning by 8:30, I suppose. Then I was totally satisfied. My God, I have earned one punya. So I will keep the mission on. I will hunt for punya. Hereafter, I'm not going to be in sorrow. With that happiness, I went to have a breakfast in the dining hall. When I had finished my breakfast, I heard the sound ambulance was coming inside, the siren song. Then I inquired, what happened? Somebody told, your neighbor fainted, he has fallen down. So what happened? No, nothing, we don't know anything. Then this ambulance rushed to the hospital and I also went to see him to the hospital. There, when I reached, the doctor was a neighbor, you know, very close person to us. He was shouting, what did he had at the last? What the different that means breakfast he had? What did have? He was shouting and the cook was, that assistant was, you know, saying that only I gave idli alone, nothing else he had. And he was shouting, I was there. Then I thought, okay, I should tell, because this is a life-threatening problem. I said, I gave this fruit to him. The doctor, he was very elder person, and he used to call me as a beta. Then immediately said, are you an idiot? Something pinched. What? Am I an idiot? No. I had the intention of earning punya. That's called dharma. I committed dharma, but I'm getting scolded as an idiot. Then I said, no, sorry, what? Then he said, You know the nature of the fruit. The nature of the fruit is to reduce the sugar level in your blood. When you had that fruits, at that time he was having normal sugar in his blood because of the tablets. Now after giving this, the sugar has, that the content of sugar has reduced, therefore what problem began? Then immediately he asked for the chocolate and he gave the chocolate. This dada became normal. I could see directly, oh my God, I had the intention to commit dharma and I made it. But giving good fruit to sugar patient, I earned papa. And giving chocolate to the sugar patient, the doctor earned punya. It's a peculiar. Gahana karmano gatihi. Then I discussed with my teacher what went wrong. Then he told the human being, we don't have the capacity completely. We may, some people may, but that's the intention. Intuition, some people, you know, they in the beginning itself, they will say it won't be appropriate, chodo. So this, even these pandits, learned people also fail to judge whether it is dharma or adharma. Therefore what? We are hopeless, helpless. Then I said, is there any solution for that? Yes, we have the solution. Then I asked, is there any karma? That which provides only punya. Maximum percentage of punya. Then he said, yes, of course, there are lots of karmas which only give punya. Then I said, what is that? Can you tell me? He said, the karmas, the actions or rituals, whatever is unfolded by Vedas, only give punya. What? Yes, the karma, the actions or rituals, whatever that is introduced by, unfolded by Vedas, our Puranas, they are only, and Agamas only provide punya. It is a beautiful way of establishing dharma. Now what are the things these Agamas, Puranas and Vedas introduce? Constructing temples, worshipping temples, doing yaga, yajna, homa, doing japa and meditation. These all will give punya. You know, japa, keep repeating Om Namah Shivaya, Om Namah Shivaya, Om Namo Narayanaya, Om Namo Narayanaya, Om Namo Venkateshaya, Om Namo Venkateshaya. So what will it produce punya phala? How? No proof. But it is valid, evident, which will be supported by your own experience. That's what the secret. Therefore, our society had engaged with constructing temples. Wherever you go, see the temple. They constructed for punya. A society which gives priority to earn punya, not to earn money. Everything what they had, they just sacrificed for the Lord. Punya phala. Nowadays there are mall culture. We are constructing the mall, consuming all the AZs. Oh, that's not our issue now. Constructing temple. Even in every street, you know, there are lots of temples. Our forefathers were not idiots. And the places for Annakshetra. So where the food are supplied, Annakshetra, Annadana, and the schools, we were never charging for the educational. Jnana Dana. And helping to the people. And doing Namaskara, you can earn punya. There are certain, you know, doing japa, doing meditations, doing good thing for others, doing, you know, offering havis on the fire ritual. You will get punya. That was our society. earning punya is the only one solution that you can have in your life. That is your lifestyle, that's the lifestyle of Sanatana Dharma. That's what called dharma. Dharma means what? The actions which brings punya, a lifestyle which brings only punya, a system which provides you punya according to your karma phala. That's the beautiful way of analyzing the subject matter. And we will continue in the next episode. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha Harihi Om.